Well, hello everyone, and welcome to FranTastic InSights, where we provide insights from some of the coolest people in franchising. My name is Alesia Visconti. I am the CEO and president of FranServe and Franchise Dictionary magazine. Now, FranServe is the world's largest franchise consulting organization, and our mission is very simple. We aim to make people's dreams come through franchise ownership. And we do that through a network of fantastic franchisors and incredible franchise consultants. And today we're fortunate to have one of the best with us, Ryan Igbanol, and he is with True North Franchise Consultant. Ryan, welcome to the show.
Alesia, good afternoon. Happy Tuesday to you.
Happy Tuesday indeed. Now, Ryan, I introduced you as a franchise consultant, but you know, when I say that sometimes out in the world, people look at me a little bit like, what the heck is a franchise consultant? So can you explain to everyone what it is that you do and what got you into franchise consulting?
Yeah, absolutely, Alesia. That's a great question. I've been doing this for a number of years. I walked out of corporate America to become a franchise consultant. And over the years, I've worked with hundreds of candidates who are considering, in some cases, doing what I did, which was leaving corporate America to work for themselves, to bet on themselves and take a chance on themselves for a variety of reasons. And from time to time, I will have to explain what a franchise consultant is, what a franchise consultant does. Look, it's not one of those professions that you say doctor, you say engineer, you say lawyer, and you immediately know what that profession does. There are no TV shows, at least not yet, about franchise consultants. Hopefully that will change in the near future. But I'm often explaining what franchise consultants do. And the great thing is that our profession is growing. But over the years, I've also used different ways of explaining what a franchise consultant does. And I think one of the most effective explanations, it's really an analogy, is in some ways, we're kind of like real estate agents. But instead of finding you the house of your dreams, let's say as a real estate agent, a client comes to me, they say, Ryan, I want a 4-bedroom, 3-bathroom house, 2,500 square feet, finished basement, backyard, all the bells and whistles. I instead find you not a house, but I find you the business of your dreams. So maybe you come to me and you tell me, well, this is what I've done for a living, Ryan. This is my profession. This is my experience. These are the kind of customers or clients that I want to service as a business owner. This is how much money I want to make. This is the kind of lifestyle I want to have. Sometimes they come to me and they say, I want to have employees, or they say, I don't want any employees. There are questions about, hey, do you want to have a home-based business or do you want a business where you go to a facility or some sort of a physical space every day? So those are the questions that I ask of every candidate that I work with. And somewhat like a realtor, I will come back and instead of showing you houses, I will come back and show you several businesses, several franchises, 4, 5, 6 different franchises that include the criteria that you shared with me. So everything I do and everything that a franchise consultant should do that's working the profession the right way is we should be asking probing questions of our candidates and we should be doing our best to understand what it is they are looking for in a business. Because for many people, especially that I work with, it's their first time. It's their first foray into exploring business ownership. And so again, if you're being an effective consultant, you are asking questions, you're listening, and you are taking the information that your client is willing to share with you and coming back and making recommendations. That's really where the consulting part of this comes in, is using our expertise and making informed recommendations that meet whatever criteria the candidate shares with you. The second part of your question is, how did I get into franchise consulting? Well, my story is very similar to a lot of the candidates I work with. I live in Philadelphia. My wife and my son and I live in Philadelphia. And I used to work in corporate America. Like so many of my candidates, I would get up early every day. I would commute into New York City, actually lower Manhattan. And I worked for a very large financial services company that had offices, still does have has offices all over the world. I had a lot of responsibility. I was actually in charge for my function of the Americas region. So Canada, United States, Mexico, the Caribbean. And the pay was great. There was a lot of responsibilities I mentioned. I got to travel occasionally. I had folks reporting to me, employees, but it wasn't terribly satisfying. The commute was difficult. It was a multi-hour commute each way. And you know, I just got to the point in my life where I said, I'd like to do something that's more impactful, something that I can get up every day and be excited about doing and look forward to. When Monday rolls around, I want to get out of bed and say, well, I'm looking forward to rolling up my sleeves and doing a great job and making a difference and having an impact. And I looked at a lot of different options, which in many ways is similar to my approach, is when I'm working with candidates, we're looking at different options. We're looking at franchises in various industries. It could be a handyman franchise, could be a home cleaning franchise, it could be an automotive repair franchise, or heck, even a mosquito control franchise. So I went through a similar process. I looked at a lot of different options, and I decided that joining FranServe and becoming a franchise consultant would give me the best opportunity to help other people achieve what I did, which was leave corporate America on your own terms. Again, take a chance, a bet on yourself, and then you know, be able to run your business and have the kind of lifestyle that you want. Again, to be able to plan out your week in advance, stick to your plan, get better, learn how to become a more effective consultant, in my case, a franchise consultant, and just get better every year. And that's what I've been able to do over the years as a FranServe consultant. And I'll tell you, I haven't looked back, and I don't mind sharing that with my candidates. I never look back. I can't imagine going back to doing what I was doing before, even though it was a good job and it was a good career and it paid well. And again, that's what I try to do for my candidates, is help them find that opportunity where they're going to be excited getting into it. And then 3 to 6 months or even 9 months later, when we talk, they say, you know what, Ryan, I'm glad I did this and I wish I had done it sooner. That is what I'm looking to achieve when I'm working with my candidates. And that's also the background into how I got into franchise consulting.
And I have to tell you, Ryan, I love the story because I think that's so true, that people in general are looking and desire to own their own business, but right, it gets overwhelming. You start looking at something, you're excited, you look at different franchises, and then the next thing you know, you almost put it on hold because it's so overwhelming and you don't know where to go. And that's really, right, that's really how a franchise consultant helps their candidate, is to narrow down and to kind of screen out some of the ones that aren't going to fit that person's dream job. And isn't that what you do? Is just help them to look at the different businesses and compare what will be ideal for them and at this point for their families, right? Because isn't franchising ownership impact not only the candidate, but also their entire family, right? Is that?
That's 100% correct, Alesia. And you use the perfect word to describe the frame of mind or the experience, especially the early experience of anybody who's exploring franchising for the first time. And that word is overwhelm. Many of my candidates come to me from a position of overwhelm. You know, Google's great. The internet's great. Any sort of information, any bit of information that you ever wanted to know, in theory, is on the internet. But to use a phrase from my previous corporate life as an employee, is it can be drinking out of a fire hose, or like drinking out of a fire hose. There's too much. So my job is to help my candidates tackle this systematically. You know, like I said, everything available under the sun is on the internet. You can access anything. But if we're trying to start from point A and get to point B, and point A is the beginning of the search, and point B is the end, where we're getting to the point where we're going to make a decision on which franchise to buy, is to help folks realize that there is a structured process. And I think that helps relieve the overwhelm. And it's a very gradual process. For most people, this could be the biggest decision that they ever make. But if they understand that there's a process and it has defined steps, and if you're doing this right, if you're running your business and you're working the profession as a franchise consultant the right way, you help them understand that there is a defined process. Hey, these 4 to 5 steps, if you follow these 4 to 5 steps, you are going to put yourself in the best position possible to make an informed decision about, number one, whether franchise ownership is for you. The second decision is, okay, the answer to the first decision is yes. Well, which franchise is the best fit for me, personally, professionally, financially, and for my family. And if you commit to all that, and I tell my candidates that, if you commit to the process, then you will be in that position to make a great decision. And you won't look back, you won't regret it, because you'll go into the process with full information.
Yeah, and you know, we even talk about it franchising so many times. You'll hear franchisors over and over again say, to be successful, follow our system. And I'm hearing from you that there's a system even in the approach of trying to decide what is the best franchise. And you know, rather than, you know, running around helter-skelter, working with the franchise consultant can really help someone follow the steps, go through the process, do the due diligence to decide what might be best for them. Now, Ryan, it sounds like you give a wonderful service. Is there a cost for your candidates to utilize your services?
Yeah, it's a great question. And I get that question a lot, especially from folks who have never heard of a franchise consultant and who are new to the industry. And a lot of people are really surprised to hear that there isn't a cost, at least not a financial cost, for my services. And I want to qualify or maybe clarify and build on that answer a little bit. While there's no financial cost, I'm never going to ask anybody to write me a check, you know, or wire me any money. My business doesn't work like that. While I say, look, there is no financial cost for my services, I do ask that people be transparent, my candidates be transparent and upfront with me. And I say, look, if you give me your time and you give me your attention and you let me know what it is you need in terms of a business and what this business needs to do for you and your family in terms of the amount of money it can generate, in terms of what it looks like on a day-to-day basis to get up and run this business, if you are willing to put in the time, that's where the investment is on the candidate's part. It is a time investment. But I would say that is exactly what a candidate who wants to buy a business is looking to do, and that is to make an investment of time up front. Because the more time that you invest up front and the more deliberate you are working the process, the better decision you're going to be able to make. And so, yes, people are often pleasantly surprised to hear that there's no monetary cost to my services. But they're perfectly okay with saying, you know what, Ryan, you're right. I'm going to put in the time up front so that we can have a thorough search and we can make sure that we do all of the due diligence. You used another great word there, Alesia. Do all of the due diligence necessary to put myself in the best position. Again, I'm speaking for my candidates, to put myself in the best position to make a great decision here and find the perfect business for myself and my family.
Awesome. And I think that really does help people to understand that transparency, being honest and open with their franchise consultant, really will help them to get the best results and in the quickest amount of time. Because when you're looking for a business, again, due diligence, following the steps, utilizing a franchise consultant, and following the system really will end up with the results that the candidate wants to earn. And that is having their own business. So I thank you for the explanation on that. And you know, just to also shed a little light, Ryan does get compensated. He does get compensated by the franchisor. So if you're not familiar with a franchise consultant and you've been in the corporate America, if you think of the way sometimes a recruiter works, they work by getting paid by the companies. And that's exactly what happens with Ryan. So you see, he does have your best interest at heart because he has hundreds of franchises that he can work with. So thank you for clarifying that for us, Ryan. Really appreciate it. Now, you know, I want to go a little bit deeper and talk about one of my all-time favorite hashtags on social media, and that is hashtag changing lives. That is what got me into franchising myself as a human being. I wanted to make a difference in other people's lives. And what I kind of say, help them find their career bliss, right? What do they want to be when they grow up? Most people want to be an owner or their own boss, and franchising really does allow that dream to come true. So, you know, I'm curious to what changing lives means to you and your firm, and if you could share a story perhaps about someone that you helped change their life, I think that would be delightful.
Absolutely. And I love that hashtag changing lives. You know, there's a lot of great things about being a franchise consultant. But I think one of the most exciting aspects of it is getting to ask a question that most of us have not been asked since we were children. And that is, what do you want to do? What is it you want to be? Not when you grow up, because everybody I work with is, just about everybody I work with has a career or has had a career, has done great things, earned plenty of accomplishments, and in many cases had a tremendous amount of success and satisfaction in a career. But nobody asks you when you get to a certain age, what do you want to do when you grow up, or what do you want to be? Well, I get to start the conversation with that question. What do you want to be for the next, and what do you want to do for the next 5, 10 years and beyond? And, you know, a lot of people are delighted that they get to hear me ask that question, that they get to be asked that question. And it opens up, it's like it opens up some sort of neural pathway in the brain and is allowing us to use a part of a brain that we haven't used since we were children. And that gets people talking. In many cases, folks will come to me and they'll say, well, you know, Ryan, I've always wanted to own a business in this industry for as long as I can remember. Maybe they even took a few steps to own a business in a particular industry, but life happened. They had a family, you know, they moved somewhere for work, they bought a house, and they went to work, they put their heads down and they did everything they could. They achieved a lot in their career. But then there was always sort of this voice in their head that said, well, what if I could get a business in that industry? And a lot of folks will come to me and they'll say, do you have anything in X industry or Y industry? And I love to be able to tell folks, yes, I do. And not only do I, well, I've got 5 great franchises, for example, in the automotive industry, many brands that you're familiar with. Let's look at those. Let's pick those apart. Let's look at the business models and let's see if these are going to be the right fit for you. And it's all, again, talking about fit, it's about matching up somebody's professional background, their experience, and again, what they want to achieve through business ownership with the franchises the hundreds of franchises that I work with. So I love asking that question. I love getting to hear people's intimate dreams in many cases when it comes to a lifestyle or a particular industry that they want to have a business in. And I've got a lot of great stories I can share. I know that I don't have time to share all of them this afternoon, but one of my favorite recent stories working with a candidate is from last year. And is a gentleman named Kevin. I won't use his last name, but he's in North Carolina. And who knows, maybe he'll see this video, maybe he'll see this interview. That'd be wonderful. I had a lot of fun working with Kevin and his wife last year. He came to me around spring of 2019, and he was looking at a home-based services franchise. And we looked, and he lives in a great area for franchising in North Carolina. And unfortunately, the franchise that we initially looked at was sold out. But part of the territory was available as a resale. And we looked at that franchise. Kevin talked to the franchisor, the home office. He talked to the owner. And he just couldn't make it work in terms of working with the owner to buy that owner's territory. That owner was looking to sell off parts of his territory. And so we had to pivot, which so often in this profession as a consultant, you will, because it's about finding solutions. And Kevin and I discussed that particular franchise wasn't going to be the right fit for him. But I emphasized, Kevin, there's so many other opportunities out there. If you're willing to use your imagination, which I tell everybody, look, this search is about imagination and expectations. We discuss both. The imagination part of this is you've got to be able to imagine yourself doing something that perhaps you've never done before, because there is so much variety. There's so many industries in franchising. But if you're willing to use your imagination, again, something that maybe you haven't had a chance to do seriously since you were a child, but if you can imagine yourself using your skills that you've acquired over the years in your career and redeploying those in a business, then sky is literally the limit for you. And that's what we did. So we looked at a lot of different franchises in several industries, all service franchises, because that's what Kevin gravitated toward. That's what he wanted. And we ultimately settled on a pest control franchise. And it was a great story. you know, Kevin hung in there. He didn't get discouraged, even though we had a near miss with that first franchise. And he and his wife ended up flying to the corporate headquarters of this pest control franchise in the fall of last year. So we started working together, I think it was April 2019. October 2019, Kevin and his wife flew to the corporate headquarters. They met the entire leadership team at the franchise home office. And they had a great feeling about that franchise. They got to talk to the owner of the franchise, who's still intimately involved in the day-to-day affairs. They flew home to North Carolina. They sat around the kitchen table. They looked at all the notes they had taken, and they made a decision. They made a decision that franchise was going to give them the best opportunity to achieve everything that they wanted to through business ownership. And they joined. They chose to join in October. And Kevin's having a ball in that franchise. And I love working with them. I love being able to get him from a position of, Ryan, you know, I've had a good career, but I'm just ready for something different, to doing something very different than what he did before. But all the same, he loved it. He loves it. And those are the kind of stories that fuel you as a franchise consultant. You just love working with people because you become a part of their lives for, you know, it could be 2 months, 3 months, it could be a year, and you're helping guide them to make the best decision possible. And it's one of the biggest decisions. Again, it's one of the biggest decisions they'll ever make. That's impact. That's powerful. And again, it's one of the primary reasons that I chose to become a franchise consultant. So many people are looking for opportunities to have that impact, to connect with people on a one-on-one level, a personal level. And hey, we get to do that. Alesia, you know, because you were a franchise consultant. I mean, you run FranServe now, but you were a franchise consultant doing exactly what I do and our colleagues do every day. You know how rewarding it is. You know how significant the work we do is. And yeah, I look forward to making as much of a difference and having as wide of an impact on my candidates as possible.
And I appreciate that, Ryan. You know, even when you're telling that story, I can hear it. I can hear the reliving when you were working with Kevin and maybe a little disappointment at the beginning and then, you know, as the success at the end. And, you know, my prior life before I got into franchising was in, you know, career coaching and helping people in life coaching. And I'm a firm believer that things happen for a reason. So this might not have been the very first choice for Kevin, but it sounds like it was the right one. And things have a way of working out like that, right? Things just have a way. You're a good franchise consultant. You help someone to see what might be the best brand for them, even if they never thought about, you know, that the industry that they're, you know, end up with. So kudos to you for guiding your candidate, and congrats to Kevin and his family for being successful franchisees. So that's great. And I have to tell you, Ryan, it's unfortunately we have to wrap things up. I appreciate your time. I know how busy you are, but I do so appreciate, you know, your fantastic insights that you provided. Now, if someone wanted to contact you, if someone was interested in working with you as you being their franchise consultant, what is the best way for them to get a hold of you?
It's a great question, Alesia. There's several ways that somebody can learn about what I do, see my professional background, and just get in touch with me about, hey, maybe you had a thought about business ownership. Maybe this is something that you have explored in the past and you've gone away from it because, hey, life happens. But maybe you've thought it's time to revisit that. It's time to revisit franchise ownership. Well, you can find me by Googling. You can type in my company name, which is True North Franchise Consulting. You can Google my name, which is Ryan Igbanol, last name spelled I, G as in girl, B as in boy, A, N as in Nancy, O, L. So I say Google me. If you want to just do the old-fashioned thing, which is type in the website for my business, which again is called True North Franchise Consulting, it's www.truenorthfranchising.com, all one word. And that's how you can find me. You can find me on Google. You can find me on LinkedIn. I love to talk. I love to strategize about, hey, how are we going to get you from what you're doing now to where you want to be? And I, like I said, I love to have that conversation. It's what gets me up every day. It's what gets me excited when Monday rolls around. And I welcome anybody to reach out and schedule some time with me. Let's do it. Let's have a conversation about what you're going to do for the next 5 or 10 years and what's going to be your next act as a professional. Hopefully that'll be franchise ownership.
Super. And we will have those links either above or below in this post. So people will be able to find you very easily. And I do recommend, if you're interested in perhaps exploring franchise ownership, that you reach out to Ryan. If you're interested in becoming a franchise consultant like Ryan, you can contact us directly at our website at franserve.com or email us at connect@franserve.com. Now, Ryan, thanks again for your fantastic insights. Any last thoughts before we wrap up?
Yeah, a lot of people ask me, hey, Ryan, when is the best time to buy a business in general? And, you know, it might sound cliche, but anytime's a good time. I know that there's been a lot of, this has been an eventful year. 2020 has thrown us a lot of curveballs. And I've had folks say, well, is now a good time to start a business? Is now a good time to start a franchise? And, you know, if you do research, again, going back to the internet, the answer to almost every one of our questions is on the internet. If you research, you know, when is the best time to start a business? And if you're looking for data and statistics, you know, there is none. You'll find quickly that there is none. And a lot of the most successful franchises that I work with started during a time where it might seem counterintuitive to begin a business. A lot of great franchises started in 2008, 2009, 2010. And it just goes to show you that there is no quote unquote best time or quote unquote worst time to start a business. Because when you're in business, franchising or non-franchising, your business is going to run that business no matter what's going on in the economy, when the economy's up, when the economy's down, when the economy's sort of humming along. And if you go into the process thinking that way, if you think this is something I'm going to do long term, this is something I'm going to continue to get better at month after month and year after year and just continue to build, then it makes sense that there is no best or worst time to start a business. The best time, I guess, is now. Again, going into this with an open mind, realizing that you are going to get into something that you're going to be doing for the foreseeable future. And that's the best way to approach this. So I'll say, start the search now. Let's have a conversation now. Just because we're having a conversation today in September 2020 doesn't mean you're going to start your business in 2020. This could be something that you're looking to do in the next 6, 9, 12 months. But the important thing is to have a conversation. Let's see what's out there. And I always move according to my candidate's timeline. So if somebody says, I want to do this 12 months from now, well, then we know this is something we'll do over the next 12 months. So I'm always happy to work on folks' timeline. And I look forward again to connecting with as many candidates as I can who are looking to achieve the same thing that I did, which is just have more control, more flexibility over your lifestyle and your livelihood. I love helping people do that.
Comes through very strong, Ryan, and thank you so much for your time. I appreciate it. And as you said at the beginning, happy Tuesday. Thank you, Ryan.
You too, Alesia.